Nu ska jag vara helt ärlig. Jag hade hört hans namn och förstått att han är den nya generationens musikaliska hjälte och romantiska dröm. Men mycket mer än så visste jag faktiskt inte. Men så började jag kika lite närmare på vem han egentligen är och insåg att jag nog hade missat en del. Han är den första artist någonsin som haft 7 låtar från sitt debutalbum på amerikanska Billboard Hot 100-listan. Och hans video till låten Baby är YouTubes mest visade klipp med 730 miljoner visningar. Han har uppträtt för det amerikanska presidentparet Obama och det har gjorts en biofilm om honom och han har fått massor med musikpriser. Och han har redan, observerat som tonåring, givit ut en självbiografi, bara en sån sak. Miljoner av fans runt om i världen bekänner sig nästan som en religion till att vara Beliebers, alltså Bieber-fans. Och i veckan var Justin Bieber i London och jag var nyfiken.
Förra året så samlades svenska fans på Sergels torg i Stockholm i en kärlekshyllning till idolen. En 18-årig kille som man redan har gjort en film om, som har släppt en självbiografi, som har 21 miljoner följare på Twitter och fans över hela världen som kallar sig Beliebers. Ett fenomen. Och i veckan var fenomenet i London för att promota sin tredje platta.
How long have you been waiting for him?
We've been up since like 5 a.m.
But why?
Because he's amazing and he's here in London. He's here in London and we love him.
Why do you love Justin Bieber so much?
Because he's like really talented and stuff and he's amazing.
And if you could ask him one question, what would it be?
Efter en del väntan så dyker de upp. Ett entourage med skivbolag, managers, sminkös, livvakt, bokningsbolag och pappa Bieber. Och så Justin Bieber själv såklart.
You now can wear a bad kind of soul.
So, in a couple of years, you went from a regular Canadian schoolboy to the biggest pop star in the world.
Yeah.
That journey, could you describe it for me?
The journey, wow. I mean, it's been pretty crazy just traveling the world and seeing so many great places. Also, just having so many great fans and believers and all around the world, being able to go to, like, the randomest places and having fans is really remarkable.
But are you able to enjoy it and to appreciate it? Because you're traveling all the time and...
Of course. I mean, I enjoy it. I try to really, you know, I can't really have time to really bask in it and really, like, understand what's going on because I'm always on the go. But, like, once I really sit down, I'm like, wow, this is pretty crazy.
You can hear them screaming right now.
Yeah.
How does it feel?
I mean, it's crazy. It's just like... you know, I haven't been back to London for a while, so, you know, having this response is always crazy.
You know, when I told them I have a show, a television show in Sweden, and I was telling them that next week I'm meeting Justin Bieber, and something extraordinary happened. Suddenly, people started to send Twitter messages to me, and a lot of people wanted to know, and they went crazy. Everybody wants to know, are you really meeting him? And they send all their love to you. Did you know, for example, that they had a big love demonstration for you on a square in the center of Stockholm?
No.
Thousands of people singing your songs with texts saying, please, Justin, come to Sweden.
Back to my Swedish fans, I would like to say thank you for the support. Hopefully I'll be able to come back there for my world tour. But we're just still figuring everything out, but I'm really excited.
How do you keep your feet on the ground? I mean, how do you keep a humble person when you have so many fans that love you around the world?
Well, I think it's all about who you surround yourself with and keeping, you know, those good people close to you, but, you know, having that those people that aren't afraid to tell you when you're, you know, when you're getting to be full of yourself.
Do you have that people around you?
Yeah, I do. I mean, my team is so great. You know, I don't have anybody that, you know, they all keep it straight with me and tell me, you know, listen, you need to do this, or, you know, you shouldn't act like this, and just try to keep me, you know, to be a good person.
It's kind of an industry around you right now. Do you feel like sometimes that it's overwhelming for you?
Yes and no. For me, it's like, I know it's a responsibility, but I'm a good person, and it doesn't really take hard. It's not that hard to just be a good person. And so, you know, there's a lot of people that look up to me, and, you know, I'm not always going to be perfect, but at the end of the day, you know, I'm 18, and I gotta, you know, sometimes you gotta make bad decisions to learn from them.
Do you do that sometimes?
Sometimes. I mean, I'm not perfect. I make bad decisions sometimes.
I noticed your dad is with you.
Mm-hmm.
And also today we were presented to some of the songs from your new mm-hmm. album. And one of the songs, you wrote it to your mother.
Mm-hmm.
What does family mean to you?
Family in general, you know, it means the world to me, you know. I never had, like, my whole life I was always, like, the only child. And recently, you know, within the past couple of years, I was blessed enough to have a little brother and sister who, you know, now I get to see, and they get to come and see me in L.A. and stuff, and it's been really cool. I took them to Disney World for the first time, which was awesome.
Just to be able to do that when you're 18?
Yeah, because, I mean, I would have never been able to go to Disney World, you know, let alone take my little brothers and sisters. So to be able to be in this position to bless them, to be able to experience those type of things is really great.
How do you think about giving back? Because you get so much love and so much experiences. How are your thoughts about giving back?
With everything I do, I try to add a charitable aspect to it, whether it's my fragrance or whether it's my tour. You know, I gave a piece of every ticket sold on my tour to charity. And I try to, like, be, you know, a philanthropist and just try to do as much as I can for charity.
If you look at the backside of fame and the things that you're experiencing right now, another of the songs that you wrote on to the album is about the girl that mm-hmm. claimed that she was having your baby.
Yeah.
What are your thoughts about the backside of fame?
There's a lot of stuff that goes on. I mean, there was rumors that I was, like, stabbed the other day on Twitter and Facebook and stuff. So, like, there's all these different rumors that happen, and you just have to deal with them, you know, and be gracious and, you know, realize that there's going to be people that make stuff up, but you got to just, you know, let people know, like, listen, you know, this is who I am and this is what I stand for, and I don't necessarily, this isn't true, but you always have to be strong about it and not let it get to you, because people are going to say stuff.
Isn't that hard? I mean, sometimes, doesn't it hurt you, your feelings?
It does. It can hurt my feelings, but, you know, I try not to let it bother me. Because, well, you know, at the end of the day, I'm human, and I do, you know, I have emotions, and some things people say can be hurtful. But, you know, what does it matter what they think at the end of the day when I have so many great fans and so many, you know, beautiful people that love me and support me? Like, why would I pay attention and dwell on people that are just being negative?
What would you say to Justin Bieber if he just showed up here?
Can we go on a dinner date?
Yeah.
Can we just spend the day together?
Yeah.
Just to see what he's like. He's amazing anyway, but...
then marry him.
Yeah.
Just one date and then you'll marry him?
Yeah. Got to see if he's suitable, won't we?
You know any of his songs?
Of course, boyfriend. If I was your boyfriend, never let you go. Keep you on my arm, girl. I can never be alone. Yeah.
I can be a gentleman. Give you everyone. If I was your boyfriend, I'd never let you go.
You've done so much. The picture, you wrote a biography, you are coming out with your third album, and you're only 18. What's left?
There's so much left to accomplish in my life. You know, I still haven't won a Grammy, and I still haven't acted in my first major picture. So, I mean, there's so many things I want to do and accomplish, and, you know, so my music is just going to evolve and become better, and you know, that's it.
But that's a professional life. What about your personal life? What are your personal goals?
Personal goals? I want to be, you know, I want to be have a young, you know, be young when I have a family. Like, not too young, but, like, you know, within the next 10 years, hope to have, like, a family.
That sounds good. Young daddy, again. Yep. So, you can't tell me anything about if you're coming to Sweden?
I can't say anything because I don't have the like the actual tour dates and everything. So I don't want to like disappoint anybody by saying, listen, I'm coming here and then not end up coming. So I can just say I really want to and you know, I'm looking forward to it. Mm-hmm. That was okay. Thank you so much.
It's a pleasure. Good luck.
Of course.
De utlovade 15 minuterna intervju avbryts av det amerikanska teamet efter ungefär 7-8 minuter. Men jag vill ge fansen som har stått där ute i regnet någonting, så jag ber Justin Bieber vinka lite åt dem.
Just made their day, Justin. Oh my god.
Och till er svenska beliebers fick vi loss 45 sekunder exklusivt från den nya videon till låten Boyfriend, som egentligen inte släpps för nästa vecka. If I was your boyfriend, I'd never let you go. I could take you places you ain't never been before. Baby, take a chance, or you'll never ever know. I got money in my hands that I really like to blow. Swipe, swipe, swipe on you. Chilling by the fire while we eating fondue. I don't know about me, but I know about you. So say hello to falsetto in 3, 2, swipe. I'd like to be everything you want. Hey girl, let me talk to you. If I was your boyfriend, never let you go. Keep you on my arm, girl. You never be alone. Så ja, alla beliebers. Där fick ni sin teg, höll jag på att säga. 15 juni kommer skivan, och den stora frågan som har kommit till mig via olika sociala medier under hela veckan är, kommer han till Sverige? Och då gjorde jag så att för att det ska vara en helt färsk uppgift så ringde jag till skivbolaget och frågade. Och de har fortfarande inte fått någon bekräftelse på att han ska komma till Sverige. Så det kanske är något av en besvikelse eventuellt. Men istället då så har jag 5 stycken exemplar, limited edition exemplar av singeln Boyfriend, med en liten sån här som man kan öppna, och så har han skrivit sitt namn där. De kan, det är bara 5, så att det är inte, alla kommer inte få det. Men däremot så får ni jättegärna skriva ett vykort. Det tycker jag är roligt. Erik Hassle står här bredvid mig och vi fascineras naturligtvis över detta fenomen. Men skriva vykort ska ni få göra, för att det är ju generationen som kanske inte skriver vykort, så ni får gärna göra det. Och så väljer vi ut 5 stycken som får den här plattan. TV4 115 79 Stockholm. Och märk gärna kuvertet med, eller fikortet med, Nyhetsmorgon söndag.